next-generation combat vehicles, RCV and OMFV. Experimental, RCV, robotic combat vehicles and virtual designs for, OMFV, optionally manned fighting vehicles are exploring bold new possibilities. The Army's next-gen troop carrier have slimmed down to smaller designs and gone to hybrid electric drive. The optionally manned fighting vehicle will also have active protection against anti-tank missiles, and OMFV will feature extensive automation, hence the name optionally manned, unmanned robotic combat vehicles that troops are already testing in the field. Together, RCV, robotic combat vehicles and OMFV, optionally manned fighting vehicle could bring a future armored force that's lighter, stealthier, less gas-guzzling, and less dependent on exposing human beings to enemy fire. That would make mechanized units more deployable, easier to resupply, and more effective in combat, if, of course, the technology and funding materialize on time. Meant to replace the M2 Bradley as the Army's frontline armored troop carrier, or infantry fighting vehicle, optionally manned fighting vehicle is in phase 2 of an innovatively structured five-part program. Five industry teams, General Dynamics, BAE Systems, Rheinmetall Raytheon Textron, Oshkosh Hanwha, and Point Blank Enterprises, are currently refining virtual designs. The forthcoming phases are detailed digital design and production of physical prototypes, with final, formal proposals due November 1st. The Army hopes for bids from all five teams, officials said, plus potentially other companies that didn't get Phase 2 contracts. The five teams now on contract have gone through three rounds of refinements already, said Major General Glenn Dean, the Army's Program Executive Officer for Ground Combat Systems, POGCS. Each cycle takes each team's digital design, runs it through computer simulations and analysis by veteran operators, and then hands that feedback back to the companies so they can make improvements. We've gone from very large vehicles to much smaller ones along the way, Dean told reporters at the annual Association of the U.S. Army conference. We've seen all five current participants go to hybrid electric designs, although each one of them is taking a different approach. While Dean emphasized that hybrid electric isn't a mandatory feature of the design, i.e. it's not a formal Army requirement, hybrid not only saves fuel, significantly simplifying logistics, but also runs much quieter than conventional tank engines. All told, and in stark contrast to an earlier, since-cancelled version of optionally manned fighting vehicle that rushed to physical prototypes, the repeated cycles of digital design are allowing a lot more innovation than in traditional programs. We're seeing different armor package configurations, said Brigadier General Jeffrey Norman, the new director of the Next Generation Combat Vehicle Cross-Functional Team, NGCV-CFD. We're seeing different track. It's going to result in a really transformational capability to replace the Bradley. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.